In partial fractions, we have the different methods. Now, in that first method is f of x by g of x is a proper fraction. In that, each non-repeated factor ax plus b of g of x, there will be partial fractions, right? Of the form a by ax plus b, right? Now, then we'll see one problem. As they give the problem, they're asking to convert into partial fractions, means the sum of the different terms. What is the degree of the numerator here? 1. And what is the degree of the denominator? We start 1. If you multiply it, these two, we'll get it x into x, x square. So the degree is 2. Clearly, degree of numerator less than degree of denominator. So it is a proper fraction. In this proper fraction, observe here, x power is how much? 1. And whole power is how much? 1. X power 1, whole power. If it is like this, this is the method we need to reach. If it is x square, different method. If it is a whole square, different method. Right? Now, if this is the method, what we need to do? Given 1, 5x plus 1 by x plus 2 into x minus 1 equal to, write down a by first factor plus b by second factor. Take it as equation number 1. These are the two partial fractions. Now, we need to find out the value of a and b. Now, see how to find out. This LHS, write down, same as it is. Take LCM of this RHS part. You get x plus 2 into x minus 1, a into x minus 1 plus b into x plus 2. If you observe the both LHS and RHS, clearly these two terms will be cancelled because both are the same terms. What is the remaining one? 5x plus 1 equal to a into x minus 1 plus b into x plus 2. Now our target is we need to find out a and b values. Now here onwards we can do two methods. One is multiply and compare corresponding coefficients. That is one method. One more method is we can use substitution method. There is a substitution method is easy compared to first method. Now here in this one, what is here? We have the term x minus 1. So for what value of x, this one becomes 0. If you take x equal to 1, then this one becomes 0, right? So x minus 1 equal to 0. So what is the x value? We'll get it 1. So this x value 1, substituting this. Substituting x equal to 1, that implies what it becomes? 5 into 1, 5 plus 1. 6 equal to a into 1 minus 1, 0 plus b into 1 plus 2, 3. So that is a 6 equal to 3b. You can cancel it too. So b value is how much? 2. See, if we substitute like this, we'll get the value is easy. We consider first part. Now what is the second part? X plus 2. Same as like this, you do it. First part, what we consider? X minus 1 equal to 0. Like that, consider the second part. What is the second part here? X plus 2. So consider x plus 2 equal to 0. What is the x value? Minus 2. Now this x value substituting. Same as like this. Substitute in place of x. 5 into minus 2 plus 1 equal to a into minus 2 minus 1 plus b into x value. Minus 2 plus 2. Now clearly what is the value? 5 into minus 2. Minus 10 plus 1. So how much? Minus 9 equal to a of minus 3 plus b into 0. So clearly minus minus cancel, 3 times also cancel. So what is the a value? We got it? 3. So finally we got the values of a and b. Now this a and b value substitute in this. So equation 1 implies. So what is the equation 1? 5x plus 1 by x minus 2 into x plus 2 into x minus 1 equal to, what is the starting value here? A. So what is the a value? We got 3. 3 by x plus 2 plus, and what is the b value? 2. 2 by x minus 1. So this is the partial fraction of the method. What again? X power 1, whole power 1. X power 1, whole power. That is, we cannot write this one into product of the two terms. So this is the method. Suppose one more if it is there into x minus 3, we need to write plus c by x minus 3. Like that. If the denominators are increasing, we need to write down all the values. So this is the first rule in the partial fractions method.